Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Himanshu Arora from Department of Anthropology, University of Delhi. Today, I am going to speak on the module Tourism Anthropology from the paper Applied Anthropology. Through this module, you will be able to learn about the subject matter of anthropology of tourism. You will learn about the theoretical origin of anthropology of tourism. You will understand the themes of anthropology of tourism. You will understand the issues of anthropology of tourism. Now let's start with a brief introduction of the module. Tourism is a rapidly growing industry in the world. It is ubiquitously present all over the world with the improved communication system. This industry has got pace and this has made this industry profitable. Large numbers of people are being involved in this industry. There is a source of huge amount of revenue for any country. It gives the opportunity to interact between host and guest, and it influences each other. As a result of tourism, cultures of both these groups are being influenced by each other. So, anthropology has a strong relation with the study of tourism. The subject matter of anthropology and tourism are relevant to each other. This is the beginning how anthropology of tourism has been evolved. Now we will briefly discuss what is anthropology. The word anthropology has been derived from two Greek words, anthropos meaning man or human and logos mean study. Anthropology is a scientific discipline that studies humankind. It thinks that human being is composed of both biological and cultural components, that they not only inherit biological qualities but also cultural qualities, culture that makes human unique in the animal kingdom. Anthropology deals with three basic aspects of human being, that is human origin, evolution and diversity. According to Haviland, there are five key themes in anthropology. These are the nature of culture, culture and survival, and formation of groups, the search for order and the change and the future. Apart from these, there are applied aspects of anthropology where anthropological knowledge can be useful to solve the practical problems. Applied and practicing anthropologists put anthropological methods, information and results to use in efforts to solve practical problems. Not only that, earlier anthropologists mainly concentrate on local life, but anthropologists now study all kinds of societies, and also because the methodological repertoire has become more varied. It has several branches like biological anthropology, social cultural anthropology, prehistoric anthropology, linguistic anthropology and applied anthropology. It also consists of lots of other sub-disciplines. Anthropology of tourism is one such sub-discipline of anthropology. Anthropology of tourism. If we look back to the history of mankind, we could find that human nature is to roam from one place to another. There are number of reasons that are responsible for which man arrange tour for a particular place. Tourism is now considered as for pleasure making. So, tourism can be defined as the combination of multiple facts which make this matter as a complex phenomenon, and it means traveling to a place which is away from home, staying there for a certain period of time. Through the process of tourism, at least two cultural groups come in contact with each other. Therefore, tourism is a subject matter of anthropology. According to Burns and Holden, anthropology and tourism have an obvious synergy. Both seek to identify and make sense of culture and human dynamics. Tourism is a global set of activities crossing many cultures. There is a need for deeper understanding of the consequences and interactions between the generating and receiving tourism societies. Anthropology has important contributions to offer to the study of tourism, especially through basic ethnography as well as the acculturation model and the awareness that tourism is only one element in culture change. Burns has pointed out that the major themes of anthropology that can be applied in the study of tourism, this may be possible like following ways. Its characteristic comparative framework, studying a variety of phenomena in different locations in order to identify common trends, a holistic approach, taking account of social, environmental, and economic factors and the links between all three, and pursue of deeper level analysis, that is, what causes tourism. Nash pointed out that the cross-cultural encounters and the consequential social transactions are the result of tourism that provide the key to the anthropologic understanding of tourism. According to Nash, processes of recognizing anthropology of tourism as a unique sub-discipline was not quite frictionless, because earlier it was considered that tourism is the domain of economists, geographers, or business managers. On the other hand, anthropologists were reluctant to recognize themselves with tourists as they considered themselves as experts in field work. Not even this, anthropologists were not capable enough to understand the significance of socio-cultural significance of tourism. Apart from this, anthropologists were not interested on modern or post-modern phenomenon like tourism. Lastly, anthropologists has not considered tourism as a serious scholarly issue of study. Theoretical origin of anthropology of tourism. The theoretical origin of anthropology of tourism was based on the ideas of some renowned social scientists like Emil Durkheim, Arnold van Gennep, and Victor Turner. Durkheim, in his essay The Elementary Forms of Religious Lives in 1915, has referred that society constantly creating sacred things among the ordinary things. In the process of creating sacred things, rituals and religions have important roles. These rituals and religion provide society more social solidarity. Sacred is something which is above the real thing. Religious thoughts bring into a certain degree of intensified psychic conditions. Nelson Greben used the concept of Durkheim's notion of the sacred, the non-ordinary experience, and the profane. Similarly, when Gennep theorized the transformation of the individuals during their life cycle and analyzed the rites of passage, he further put forwarded that rites of passage consists of three elements. These are separation, liminality, and incorporation. Separation is a ritual through which a person is separated from society and ordinary life. Liminality is a period of isolation or seclusion after the period of separation. Incorporation is a period of reintegration into the society with a new social status. The rituals under rites of passage have the capability of strengthening the collective sentiments. From here, Victor Turner developed the idea of transitions. According to him, in social rituals, norms and values are saturated with emotions. At the same time, gross and basic emotions become ennobled through the norms and values. There are certain behaviors which are not accepted in normal life, but in special situations, these behaviors accepted by the society. For instance, drinking of alcohol is not accepted in Indian society, but in ceremonial time it is accepted to some extent. In case of a traveler, when he move out for travel trip, he has to pass through series of rituals before leaving of home. This period may be considered as separation. When he roams in his trip, this period is known as liminality. At the end of his trip, when he returns back to his home, and get involved in his daily life, this period is known as incorporation. Tourism may be considered as sacred. It is a word worship. It is worship like totem as described by Durkheim. Tourism might be seen as totem of freedom. Thus, worshipping of tourism is a symbol of social and economic freedom. Tourism is a form of imperialism. Tourism is considered as an incursion of the urban culture into the rural culture. It has been damaging the rural culture brought by the urban culture for the sake of tourism. Even this destruction process goes on unconsciously and unintentionally by the superordinate culture over subordinate culture. According to Nash, there are several themes which have been influenced by the study of tourism from social science perspective. Following are the summaries of those themes. Touristic development should not be analyzed without considering productive centers that are responsible for generating surplus to enable leisure tourism and tourists. Tourism creates a controlling mechanism by the generating regions over the receiving regions. As a result of that, generating regions make an imperialistic approach and tourism a form of imperialism. A kind of demand and supply relationship are developed through which a supportive infrastructure is developed in the form of swimming pool, air conditioning, fast food beverages and so on, which are not generally found naturally or traditionally. An unequal transaction takes place between local people and tourists. Thus, a host and guest relationship is grown up. Due to economic disparities between hosts and guests, a sense of superiority or superordinate feeling is developed among the guests. They feel free to act as per their own self-interest. In case of an economically less capable country, tourism system may subsume the general economy to fulfill the needs of the fleeing tourists and strangers in vacation. Themes of anthropology of tourism. Zafar Zafari has explained how five key themes of anthropology, the nature of culture, culture and survival, the formation of groups, the search for order and change and the future are interconnected with tourism. Zafari has subdivided the tourism system into two subsystems, the generating regions and the receiving areas. The generating regions supply an outpouring of tourists. The receiving areas absorb an inpouring of tourists. He further placed these two subsystems within the context of the zones of mutual interdependence. He then tried to build up a relationship between demand and supply, which is beyond the concept of economics. According to him, the industrialized or post-industrialized countries are dependent upon recreative satellite areas, failing to provide recreational goods to their citizens. As a result of this, they have to shift their attention to other locations. This theme of anthropology of tourism is quite different from the political scientists. Necessity of anthropological study of tourism. There are ample scopes for anthropologists to study on tourism. Tourists provides opportunity to interact various cultures and subcultures. Therefore, chances change may be studied through anthropology. On the other hand, tourism is a widespread global phenomenon. It happens all over the world, irrespective of the complexity of the human culture. Necessity of anthropological study of tourism. Not only this, tourism provides an opportunity to experience the non-instrumental travel, which is for the purpose of recreation of mind. Lastly, tourism is responsible for transformation of pre-industrial world in contact with the industrial or post-industrial world. All of these reasons ultimately help anthropology to find out the underneath value systems of the complex and interconnected societies of modern world by considering tourism as a part of general social process. Approaches of anthropology of tourism. Malcolm Crick has categorized the inquiry of anthropology of tourism in three strands: semiology, political economy, social and cultural change. Semiology. As Ferdinand de Sozor has explained, it is the study of meaning and relationship between image and symbol, which is known as signifier, and the meaning associated with it known as signified. This signifying process is done through denotation and connotation by the members of the society. During a period of visit to location, tourists try to imply special significance of a particular place, culture, and even an object, though these things are non-significant in themselves. Political economy. It studies the phenomenon of power and control and forces that are responsible for tourism development in a particular area. It tries to examine political aspects of development and economy for an event associated with tourism. Social and cultural change. It studies the process of commoditization of a particular space, culture, and object due to the interaction of generating and receiving areas. Issues of tourism anthropology. According to Burns, there are following four issues related to tourism anthropology, which may be explained by the respective questions. Tourism as religion and ritual. Is tourism a modern form of religion or pilgrimage? Tourism as social change. Does tourism damage culture? Tourism as symbolism and mythology. Can tourism offer paradise on earth? Tourism in local global relationships. Will tourism bring development? Tourism as religion and ritual. Is tourism a modern form of religion or pilgrimage? In pilgrimage, sacred places are visited by pilgrims. During this journey, they have to pass through certain rituals. After visiting the sacred place, they will return back to the home. These rituals may be considered as separation from daily life. During this limited period, visit to the sacred place, various relationships are developed with other pilgrims, irrespective of their class, which is known as role reversal. This sort of spending of time provides mental satisfaction to the pilgrims. So, tourism may be considered as a form of pilgrimage as it includes various rituals before going to a destination. Further, Burns has tried to indicate pilgrimage as paying tribute to the culture rather than religious. But he also mentioned that hardly in all tourism there is a chance of role reversal, because in case of travel agent scripted package tourism, there is no scope of role reversal. This kind of tourism has very less difference from the daily life of the tourist. So it is difficult to come in a single agreed definition of tourism and tourists. It may be considered that tourism provides knowledge regarding others' thought on culture. So a rich ethnographic research is required for establishing the fact that tourism is a pilgrimage. Tourism as social change. Does tourism damage culture? Generally, tourists come from different cultural or subcultural background. Therefore, it is obvious that a kind cultural exchange takes place between the host and the guest. This cultural exchange may lead to the cultural change. Then a valid question may arise that whether this cultural change is beneficial or detrimental. Tourism is a kind of interaction between the host and the guest through which both the sides face a reciprocal cultural change. These cultural changes are dependent upon following factors: type of the tourist, their length of stay, attitudes and expectations, the number of tourists, the length of season, the role of the cultural brokers or marginal men. Here come the cultural broker or marginal men. Means multilingual and innovative mediators that can control or manipulate local culture for tourists' purpose. They are responsible for manipulation of local culture for the sake of tourists' purposes without affecting the cultural identity. Apart from this, there are other pressures on host-guest relationship as identified by Burns and depicted in the figure. Pressure on host-guest relationship. The main objective of the tourist is not to come in contact with the local people, rather to move away from their daily activities, monotonous regular life, to have a joy and holiday. So according to Burns, there are some other areas which are needed to be explained on host-guest relationship. These are the demonstration effect, internal and external exchange, acculturation and cultural drift, and cultural symbiosis and assimilation. The demonstration effect. It is a kind of effect which resulted for imitating the tourist by the local people at the tourist site. Generally, there are certain stereotypes exist among local people at the tourist site that tourists belong to the superior culture and well-to-do families. Therefore, younger generations are very much susceptible to be influenced by the demonstration of the tourist. Local young folks start to emulate lifestyle, dress, and the language of the tourist, though it is difficult to supplement it by the evidence that these things are happened only through the effect of tourism. There are some other factors like modernization, globalization, and so on. Internal and external exchange. Every culture is susceptible to cultural change. There are no cultures stagnant in nature. It means every culture changes at least by two processes. One is internal and another is external. According to Burns, in case of internal process, changes come from innovation, invention, and creativity. Here, the rate of such change is slow in the simple society than the complex society, whereas in case of external process, changes come through the process of modernization, westernization, and external pressure in the form of economic, political, cultural, and environmental. Tourism is one such channel through which external changes take place. Acculturation and cultural drift. Acculturation is a process of culture change when two cultures come in contact with each other and borrow their ideas and materials. This borrowing is unequal in nature. The complex society will dominate over the simple society. Therefore, the simple society will borrow more cultural components of the complex society. Cultural drift is a process when temporary cultural changes take place. The cultural drift takes place on the basis of time contact of these two cultures. If cultural contact takes place for more time, then the cultural changes are permanent. Otherwise, it is temporary in nature. Cultural symbiosis and assimilation. Cultural symbiosis and assimilation, both of these terms are derived from the term acculturation. When we talk about two cultures having unequal economic status, then we use the term acculturation. However, when we talk about two cultures having equal economic status, then we use these two words. So when two cultures started to diffuse each other one point of time and when they started to converge together, then these processes are known as cultural symbiosis and assimilation respectively. Tourism as symbolism and mythology. Can tourism offer paradise on earth? It's been seen that the name of the hotels are kept with the word paradise. It is tried to symbolize the place as a paradise, place lots of heavenly features. According to Graham Denn, there are four types of paradise in front of the tourist. He studied more than 5,000 images featured on almost 500 pages in 11 British holiday brochures. These four types of paradises are as follows. Paradise contrived. No people, natives as scenery, natives as cultural markets. Paradise confined. Tourist only, tourist ghetto. Paradise controlled, limited contact with locals, natives as servants, natives as entertainers, natives as vendors. Paradise confused, further contact with locals, attempt to enter local only zones, natives as seducers. Natives as intermediators, natives as familiar, natives as tourists, natives as tourists as natives. It is the process of depicting tourist site as paradise. In tourism brochure, there are hardly host and guests are depicted together through images. It is tried to showcase that local people are the creator of the paradise. In case of rural area, local people or hosts are projected to welcome guests as a part of their family. On the other hand, in urban area, hosts are projected as to welcome you with smiling face. In both the case, it is tried to picture tourists are not alone during their tour in the new area. Tourism in local global relationship. Will tourism bring development? Tourism is considered as an industry which is running the global economy. Therefore, it has a deep impact over the life of the people. Thus, anthropologists can play an important role in this industry. It is seen that in many cases where tourism is playing as a factor of development, therefore local global relationship must be observed, because local people have the economic potential in this development. On the other hand, the tourism system can be enriched by the anthropological field work and observation. Apart from this, recognition of social institutions and organizations must be contextualized with the anthropological insights for the developmental process. So, tourism system should be developed from local to global rather than tourism from above. Thus, tourism can bring a developmental process which is quite beneficial for the local people. Now, we'll summarize what we have studied till now. Anthropology is the study of human origin, evolution, and variation. Interactions among people are the principal factors in tourism rather than business. Anthropology provides an approach through its comparative framework to study the local and global scenario by emphasizing the social, economic, and environmental domains. The current anthropological understanding is that tourism is a complex phenomena involving various events and facets. According to Crick, tourism may be studied by the anthropologist through the categories of semiology, political economy, and socio-cultural change. Thank you.